Hey there folks, welcome to Wall Street Mojo's investment banking tutorial, and today's topic is return on capital employed. So basically the return on capital employed is the amount of earnings before interest and tax which you have, you know, which you have got or which you have achieved by employing a certain level of capital. So when I say by employing a certain level of capital, I mean to say employing both the equity and debt. Alright. So as against the ROE, wherein only the equity part is, you know, taken in for the analysis, while calculating ROCE, what we do is we take both the equity and debt part of the capital. Alright. So now the formula is relatively simple. What we need to do is, so basically we need to be calculating EBIT. EBIT is earnings before interest and tax. And we would also need capital employed. So capital employed can be calculated as total assets less current liabilities. Okay, so total assets less current liabilities would give us a complete picture of the capital employed. Alright, so let's get back to the website here and see what the computation here is given. So as you can see, the ROCE for Home Depot has been increasing from 2010 onwards, and it has been, you know, increasing at a very steady rate, you know. So that is, from 2010 it was somewhere in 16% level, and from there on it has increased to 46.2% at the end of 2016. So this tells us that, you know, Home Depot is really using, you know, its capital in a very constructive manner, right? So let's look at some computation which is given here. So now if you see, ROCE ratio is net operating income, EBIT is also called operating income, divided by the total assets less current liabilities, right? So now if you look at the revenue for the year, yeah, so how would you achieve EBIT? So EBIT is basically revenue less the OPEX. So when I say OPEX, I mean operating expenditure. Alright, so all of the operating expenditure, if you reduce these operating expenditure from the revenue, you would get EBIT. Alright. So if you see the EBIT for this particular computation here, the revenue is $3.3 million less the COGS, which is cost of goods sold, which is $2.3 million, which gives us the gross revenue as $1 million, and then the direct cost is $400,000, and then the gross margin is this much, and then the rent and general and administrative expenses, you know, getting deducted as total expenses, which would give us $250,000. So gross margin is also called gross profit at times, and this less $350,000 gave us $250,000, and this is EBIT. Now, once we have the EBIT number, we can go ahead and open the balance sheet to calculate the capital employed. Now, capital employed is a simple thing. You know, you need the total asset part, which is given in the total asset side of the balance sheet, and less the current liabilities. So current liabilities would be, you know, clubbed in the current liabilities part, and, you know, you would just get it there. So before showing a computation live, I would say that this particular ratio is, you know, applicable more in the companies wherein, you know, which are capital intensive. All right and capital intensive, when I say capital intensive, I mean those companies which have a certain amount of debt in their books. All right so debt like utilities, or, you know, some mining company. All right so these are the kind of companies which can be used to calculate ROC. But some other company which is not that much of capital intensive, like some biotech company or some small company, you know, it does not make sense to calculate the ROC, because primarily, you know, there would not be any debt as such, okay? Any public company which is small, right? So now let us look at the computation of capital employed and return on capital employed rather, and then we can wrap this up. So if you go to Edgar, you know, you would find the value for capital employed for Colgate Palmolive. So let's look at Colgate Palmolive. So let's go to Edgar and type in the company name. Yeah, so this is the company. Now if you look at the 8K or maybe 10K, you know, you would, 10K is basically the annual report. So if you look at the 10K here for Colgate Palmolive, you would have something like selected financial data, or maybe you can just scroll down and look at the value for, look at the balance sheet and also the income statement to get the numbers which we want. So here is the net sales given, and you see this operating profit. So the total operating profit for the company is for the year 15, 16 and 17 is 2.7 billion, 3.8 billion and $3.5 billion. Now let me also show you in the income statement format. So we don't have the income statement format given here. The cash flow is given here and the balance sheet. Yeah, so balance sheet is given here. Now from balance sheet we can readily calculate the capital employed. So total assets is, the value for total assets is, let me just, you know, copy this line item. So total assets is this. So this is the value for, so this is the value for 17 and this is the value for 16. Now total assets less current liabilities. Current liabilities for 2017 and 2016 is what we are looking for. So 20 current liabilities is total current liabilities. You see this total current liabilities? You just copy these values 3, 4, and mind these numbers are in millions. So you know you have to be so if it is 3408 million, that means it is $3.4 billion, as it's a huge company. So 3.4 billion and 3.3 billion. So now total assets less current liabilities would give us what? Capital employed for 17 and 16. So capital employed would be $9.2 billion for 17, and in the same way $8.8 billion for 16. Alright, so now we have the denominator part of the equation. The numerator part of the equation is, it might be given over here. Yeah, so operating profit is given here. You know, this is EBIT. This is EBIT and this is 3.5 billion and 3.8 billion respectively for 17 and 16. So yeah, so let me just, you know, take these numbers above, or let it be here. Now ROCE would be what? ROCE would be this by capital employed. Okay, now this is in points, this is in the general format, but let me put it in percentage terms. So 3.3872% is the ROCE for 17 and 43% was for 16. So from 16 to 17 the ROCE has reduced. Now in a similar fashion, you would want to, you know, ascertain the ROCE for the industry, because these numbers just does not mean anything unless and until you have the value for the industry. So what you need to be doing is, you need to go here and go to Google Finance or maybe Yahoo Finance to find the company's industry, and then, you know, take the values from there. You can, once you have the values for there, then you would be in a better position to, you know, relate and compare the numbers. Alright, so since Colgate Palmolive is a consumer good company, you might, you know, see it so Colgate So I think we'll have to look at by the ticker symbol. So ticker symbol for this is, all right, Colgate Colgate Palmolive India Limited, Colgate Palmolive Company NYSE, Colgate Palmolive Company Frankfurt. So we need the one which is NYSE. This is India Limited. This is a subsidiary of the parent company. We need this one, right? So if you come to the statistics, so if you come to statistics, you would see the return on assets, return on equity, these are the management effectiveness ratios, and in the similar fashion we have got ROCE, but it is not given here. And also if you look at the profile, you would see the sector as consumer goods and industry as personal products. Now if you go to just Google Finance, I think I've opened it here, so just type in Google Finance and or maybe just type Colgate-Palmolive. So this is what the company is. And if you look at the compare, if you go to compare, you would find the companies which are in the similar sector. So you can simultaneously calculate the value for Procter and Gamble, Unilever, Johnson and Johnson, Nestle, and L'Oreal, and then you can compare it with what you have for Colgate-Palmolive. All right, so in that way you would have a better understanding of what the return on capital employed for Colgate-Palmolive is with respect to the other players in the market. So to reiterate once again, return on capital employed is a good profitability measure of a company, and it will help you understand, what the company is, what the company, how the company is, employing its capital. But at the same time, you need to be wary of those companies who have got lots of cash on their balance sheet, because if there's cash on the balance sheet, you need to adjust that cash as well. All right. So as of now, you just need to understand that return on capital employed is a ratio of EBIT and total capital employed, which is nothing but total assets less current liabilities. I hope you've enjoyed this. And bye for now.